Good afternoon, sir. Hello, good afternoon, sir.
Afternoon.
Shall we start, sir?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Good afternoon and welcome back for post-lunch session of day one, technical session two, discipline, a key to success. Let's start off the session with a beautiful quote that says, discipline is doing what you know needs to be done, even when you don't want to do it. With these few words, I hand over the session to you, sir.
A very good afternoon, honorable principal, heads of departments, and faculty members, and my dear participants of the today student development program. The topic we have this afternoon is discipline, a key to success. It's the most important in life. Discipline is very, very important. You need to have it. Discipline helps to overcome the challenges which people might face it in life, maybe in the academic world or sports, games, or whatever you have it. It's your passion, whatever you have it. Discipline helps to overcome the challenges people encounter in the journey towards the progress, whatever the progress you want to make it. There are a number of obstacles that comes to our life, but discipline can help us to overcome that. Say, for example, you want to get up every morning at 5 o'clock. And once you start practicing, even if you sleep late night for some reason, you automatically wake up next morning at 5 o'clock. Once you make it a habituation, and that will happen automatically, can happen. That's the power of disciplines. It helps to deal with those inevitable days where some problems, there may be disappointments, and when things aren't working properly also, still you'll be able to get through because of you have the discipline power, the power of discipline, you have it. Discipline doesn't mean control. We are not going to control anybody here. It has to be self-discipline. Don't expect somebody to come and monitor it. You need to have that power of self-discipline is more important. It's about having some sense to do what you exactly you needed. You need to have some sense to do what exactly needed for you to excel in your life. And don't get tempted by the friends and relatives. Somebody asks you to come. You say, no, this is what I need to do it. And after that, yes, I'm available to you. That's what you need to talk about. And what is needed, but not what you want to do it. What is needed, but what not what you want to do. That's what we need to focus it. And that's very, very important. What is needed, but not. Lack of persistence is one of the major causes of failure. Why people are failing in whatever the activity to take up, because they're not continuing that habit for a long time or practice for a long time. Persistence approach is required. You need to focus on it. Otherwise, you lose out the thing. Let's say, I'll say tomorrow, I'll tell my mom tomorrow morning onwards, I'll get up at 5 o'clock and do some kind of exercise. And every morning I say, fine, today is okay, tomorrow onwards. When is that tomorrow is going to come, my dear friends? So please don't do that. Once you take a decision, you need to implement. That's why it's a self-discipline. It's not somebody's imposing on it. It's not a control exercise by somebody. Lack of persistence is one of the major causes of failure for people failing in the activities, what are they? My experience with lakhs of students, over 4 decades of my experience with the students, lakhs of people has proved that lack of persistence is a weakness common to majority of the students, what we are seeing. They say something, but tomorrow again, they're not implementing it. and it habit continues. And that's where you need to have self-control. You need to have it. It's very, very important. Discipline is the bridge between the goals and accomplishment. What are the goals you set for yourself you want to accomplish? It is a discipline which can take you to accomplish the goal, can happen it. And every extraordinary success is a culmination of accumulation of thousands of ordinary disciplined efforts. Every extraordinary success is accumulation of thousands of ordinary disciplined efforts. That small things can make a big thing. Are we having the discipline even to take up small things can transform it? You know, one is, I can say college, sorry, your network not working, some excuse I could have rang up and told. No, once I've taken the commitment, I must be there on time. And that's my habit right from 1984, one second time I'm there. I always reach the institution where I was working at least 15 minutes before, never late. And never left at sharp, let's say 5 o'clock is the timing, I never left at five. It is most often used to be 6:37 because my boss told me, you have no right to keep any paper pending for more than 24 hours on your table. And that I practice. And any paper which comes to my desk, it is cleared the same day. Before I leave the college, I used to clear all the papers. These are supposed emails. I immediately clear it. That's how I work on it. And thanks to my boss who taught me in 1984. Unfortunately, he's no more today, but he's the one who taught me all this. We have no right to keep anything pending. Let's say your faculty has given that you have to submit the assignment by, let's say, 25th of May. But what happened? Today, we're already in 27th. 2 days already delayed. How can you delay things? The same way, if your mom delays in preparing food for you in the morning, or she doesn't keep your dresses ready for you, what will happen? Then why are you getting angry on your mom? So my dear young friends, think about it. You need to have the discipline. So every extraordinary success is a culmination of thousands of ordinary disciplined efforts for getting. I'd like to wish all of you extraordinary success to each one of you. You can read one word, life. We have only one life given by the God to us. It depends on us how we use it or lose it, this opportunity is given by the God to us. And life, I put it in a different context, L-I-F-E. Learning is fun and experiential. You need to focus on experiential learning. Experimental learning is more important. Make learning fun. Don't take it as a punishment. You say learning is a fun. Experiential can be it. Life can be sometimes brutal. It's very, very common. Life is ups and downs, very common. Life can be sometimes unforgiving nature. It's all things. So be careful, my dear friends. You need to hustle. If you commit to some mistake and you are caught, that's all. And people will not trust you. Once, okay, second, okay, third time is gone, the people will not trust you. So it's very, very important. You need to have discipline. You need to focus on it. And one word to sum up the difference between the great people and average people. The people who achieved great success in their life and the people, average people like you and me, successful and nobodies in the world. The people who succeeded and the people who are nobody in the world. Nobody knows about them. And one word or one attribute to describe the differences, discipline between them. That's all. Discipline distinguishes from one person to the other person what you have it. You need to have that. Once you give a word, you must stand by it, whatever may happen. That's very, very important. You need to focus on it. Let's say you said that you will do it tomorrow. That tomorrow must happen. It. You can't keep on postponing. Things cannot happen. That means you lack discipline. If you don't have the discipline, then you can forget the success. Success cannot come, my dear friends. Without discipline, you can't get the success. It's just not possible at all. Think about it. And most important is, I would say, self-discipline. Because you're all now grown up, you're an 18 plus age group, you need to have self-discipline. Don't expect your parents or teachers to monitor you. No, not possible. Now you need to take the self-responsibility. Self-discipline is the ability to control one's feelings and overcome one's weaknesses. I repeat again, self-discipline is the ability to control one's feelings and overcome one's weaknesses. This is the official definition of self-discipline. You need to overcome your feelings and overcome the weaknesses what you have, because all of us got some strengths and weaknesses. You need to have the control on the feelings, otherwise it keeps diverting our mind. We need to stay focused. Ability to pursue what one thinks right, despite temptation to abandon it. I repeat again, ability to pursue what one thinks right despite temptation to abandon it. Like say, eating junk food. We all know that eating on the roadside food is not healthy. And but in spite of that temptation, you just deviate and again go and eat. Chalo yaar, aaj ek din ke liye chalta hai, no problem. What will happen? When are you going to stop that? So my dear friends, you need to have that self-control. Able to pursue what one thinks right despite temptation to abandon it. That's an area where you need to focus on it. Self-discipline begins with the mastery of your thoughts. Control your thoughts. You must have the control on your thoughts. Mind keeps debating here and there, all that will happen. You need to have control on that. It's very, very self-discipline begins with the mastery of your thoughts, what you have it. If you don't control what you think, you can't control what you do it. It's very, very important. Let's say when you're taking up a book on, let's say, physics, you must stay focused on physics. While reading physics, you can't be thinking about chemistry or commerce or management or maybe some friend there, some relative there, some event there that will not happen. So if you don't control what you think, you can't control what you do. It's not going to happen. And I talked in the morning, but same thing, I'm extending it now. We talked about 3 Ds, discipline. You need to have discipline in achieving success. You need to have the dedication to the purpose for which you joined this college and determination to your best performance. If you ignore any one of them, defeat will come to you automatically, my dear friends. You need to take care of these 3 Ds, discipline, dedication, and determination. Otherwise, defeat will come to you. I can prove it mathematically this. All of you keep the paper and pen ready. Keep the paper and pen ready. Write on a single line 10 into 10 into 10 into 10, 5 tens. 10 into 10 into 10 into 10 into 10. Equal to how much? Type in your answers. I repeat again. On a paper, you write it 10 into 10 into 10 into 10 into 10. Equal to how much? Come on, you have some of your maths background, accounting background. You should go and talk about it. Yeah, good. Somebody start typing it. I'm happy. Someone had typed 5 lakhs. How come it becomes 5 lakhs? I want to know. The very first person has typed 5 lakhs. No, sorry, friends. 1 lakh. Okay, fine. That's okay. Fine. That's okay. No problem. We understand. Okay. Now, next line, you write it again. Sorry, please stop there. Next line. Right now, only 4 tens. 10 into 10 into 10 into 10. Only 4 tens. Wait for further instruction. Wait for further instructions. I'm not completed. 10 into 10 into 10 into 10. 4 tens you're written. The last one you say into 5. How much it is? So look at it. Earlier you said 1 lakh, now you cut down by 50%. Instead of 1 lakh, now you say 50,000 only. Okay, fine. Now next, again write it once more. 4 times, 10 into 10 into 10, 4 times. And the last one you say into 0, how much it becomes? Oh, 0. Look at it. My dear friend, is less. That's enough. The thing to be learned is now, each and every subject is important. Each and every topic is important. Each and every concept is important. If you ignore any one of them, this is how your performance will fall down. Take it from me. Each and everything is important in life. Each and every subject is important. Each and every chapter is important. Each and every concept is important. We don't know where it's going to be useful to us in our lifetime. So hence, you need to learn everything what is taught as part of a curriculum in the syllabus in the college. You need to learn each and everything. In fact, you should be able to go beyond the textbook. If you start ignoring, chalo, theek yaar, these 4 chapters we'll read, that's enough. But what will happen if the question comes from the 5th chapter? I can share an experience. Once my students has applied to Amazon for the job campus recruitment, they came and they had initially looked at the marks from there. They shortlisted some students. Then they had conducted aptitude test, further shortlisting has happened. And then next they had a HR round, further shortlisting happened. Then there is technical round for this. So 6 rounds, these are 6 rounds happened every time shortlisting is happening. The finally 3 students were left over. Amazon is a good company, all of you are aware. People want to read. 100 students applied, finally 3 students were remaining. and the six rounds of is over, then the team said, you have one more round of interviews, it's just a formality. Our senior vice president would like to meet you before we issue the offer letters. And you have to come to Bangalore and we will give the flight charges. So these three students were excited. Okay, fine. Company is giving us flight tickets. We'll go there. And it's just a formality. So we're going to come back with the offer letters. This is the impression they had. So on the scheduled day, they all went there to office, Bangalore office. And they went and reported to the reception. Yes, we have come for this purpose and this is what we are here. And that lady said, so please sit down. And there's still another 10 minutes time is there because it's only 9:50. You have been called at 10 o'clock, so we'll call you. 10 o'clock sharp. Now they start calling one by one. Actually, all three can't do that. So the first person went inside. It is a post for HR recruitment. Let me tell you. HR manager. Some of you should be able to understand it. And this student went inside, came back in a totally upset mood. Then they did not allow this person to meet the other two. Okay, that's what they done. They called the second student to come inside. This fellow went there again, came back in upset. Third student again been called, the last one, to enter inside. You know what happened? It is a recruitment for a position of HR manager. They expected some questions on HR or just a formality courtesy call and they will offer it. They will give the offer. This is what the impression they had. What the senior vice president has done is for each one of them, he started asking questions in the area of economics. And that's over. See, look at how he related economics to HR and he says, now you should know economics. Luckily, the third student has done B economics. And then they were pursuing MBA because I was working in MBA college. And that student could answer and that fellow got it, the other two did not get it. Lower, look at it. So hence, it's very, every subject is important, every chapter is important, every concept is important, otherwise this is the way you looked at performance, 150,000 to zero will happen. So my dear friends, focus on it, it's very, very important. So it is a discipline to work hard. Mehnat ka phal meeta hota hai. It's very, very important. You need to put in the hard work. Let's say you want to go to the third floor of a building. One is to go by the lift. The second is to go by staircase. If you go by the staircase, you are bound to reach the third floor. If you go by the lift, you may or may not reach the third floor. There may be electrical failure. There may be mechanical failure. After going to third floor, the lift may not stop it. Or even if you're reaching third floor, the doors may not open, or suddenly the lift may come down suddenly because of some mechanical issues. Whereas if you go with the staircase, you're bound to reach the third floor. Hence, it's very, very important. It is a discipline to work hard, it's very important. My dear friends, you need to work hard. It's very, very important. Not when everyone is watching, but when no one is watching, what is that you're doing? Let's say when your parents are watching you, when your teachers are watching you, you are reading or sometimes you're pretending as reading. But when nobody is watching, what is your behavior? The way some of the youth, they do it on the traffic signals when no police constable is there, even the red light, they jump the signal. That is your behavior. Okay. So hence, my dear friends, not when everyone is watching you, but when no one is watching you, what is your behavior? Is what is more important when you talk about discipline, is what you need to look at it. That's an area where you need to talk about it. And when the teachers or parents are there, what is that you are doing it? How you are behaving it? What you are doing it? All that is important. When it's just you and your character will come out. I have a question, my dear young friends. What is the difference between conduct and character? What's the difference between conduct and character? I hope when you came out of the school, they would have given you character certificate. Your school and at 12th, they would have given you character certificate. Yes or no? Or even the transfer certificate they write. The school or college, they would have given the character certificate. Yes or no? Yes or no? I'm watching your answers. Go ahead. Yes, some more people? Good. Thank you. That's enough. Please stop. No more typing, please. No more typing. That's wrong answer. That's wrong answer. No schooler. My dear friends, you seem to be too smart. I didn't ask what is the different conducting character. That's I talk about later. I'm right now asking, did your school give you character certificate? No school or college will give you character certificate, my dear young friends. Please note this. Nobody can give you. Only the most your parents may give you character certificate. Nobody can give you that. Conduct is external behavior. Character is internal behavior. Internal, we can't judge it. So that's the reason schools and colleges can't give you character certificate. They'll only give you conduct certificate. So please note this. Conduct is external. Character is internal. This is what the difference is. I know you people are typing long things. There's no need. Make life simpler. Don't make complicated by giving such long answers. That's all over. Okay, fine. So you need to focus on the discipline to eat strong and healthy food when you have other tempting options available, like eating pani puri, chaat bhandar on the roadside. The discipline to eat strong and healthy food in spite of the temptations to eat the chaat bhandar roadside is a question to look at it. So it's very, very important unity of the discipline. The discipline to say no when your friend says, let's go and have pani puri on the roadside, you need to have it. No, sorry, somebody is typing character is looking good and dress sense. No, that's not character. Sorry. No. Character is internal, my dear friends. Anyway, we'll come back. So the discipline to say no is very, let's say your friend is asked, let's go and have pani puri on the roadside. You should be able to say no. Let's say you took a decision that today evening, 7 to 9, you will finish some homework or assignment which is pending with you. But around 7:30, your friend calls saying that let's go for a dinner together. You should be able to say no. It's very, very, that's what we said discipline. Because you are taking a decision, 7 to 9, today you will sit and finish the pending work, what is there in your table. But instead of that, what happened? 7:30, when your friend calls, he says, okay, I'm coming. You are leaving this work and going away. So learn to say no. It's very, very important. Discipline to say. When you're trying to work on something serious, my suggestion would be, please switch off your mobile phone. I will keep disturbing you. That's what you can do. The discipline means once made, no negotiations at all. And no other choices, no other options is what you need to read. Morning, I was telling you, Dangal movie. The once the decision is taken, they are stayed focused on the achieving the winning the competition. That's what they are focusing on. No other choice. Just focus on it, work on it. And success will come, bound to come. If not today, tomorrow, I will get the success. Bhagawan ke ghar mein der ho sakta hai, lekin andher kabhi nahi, my dear friends. So discipline means once made, no negotiations, no other choices, no other options is what you need. 99% people are not willing to do what it takes to make the dreams come true. This is the reality I'm telling you. 99% of the people are not willing to do what it takes to make their dreams come true. They have always excuses. They say, no, my friend has come, my friend's marriage is there, party is there, this and that there. That's the anyway, tomorrow I'll submit. All that will not happen, my dear friends. That's the problem. We are facing it. Fine. You see, someone has tried to, sometimes if we deny to our friends, they might break the relation with us. Yes. You need to be polite, but firm, you need to say that. Yes, my dear friend, I'd like to come. But this is what the work which is right now pending, and tomorrow morning I have to submit it. It will be difficult for me if I can't complete it. And tomorrow I can spare time for you. You ask only half an hour, I can spare 2 hours for you. That's what you can do. Unless an emergency, okay, if friend is a serious danger of life, then okay, you can go. Otherwise, you have to say no. You can't sacrifice your career for the other person's sake, my dear friends. Please note this. And let me also tell you, today we don't have true friends. We have friends, that's all. I always say, to give life to a friend is nothing great. To give our life to a friend is nothing great. does he really deserve that kind of sacrifice from us? I want to know. I repeat again, to give life to your friend, your life to your friend is nothing great. Does he really deserve that kind of sacrifice from us? Today we don't have true friends. They are friends, that's all. There's a reality of life. So 99% people are not willing to do what it takes to make their dreams come true. Today they say, but tomorrow once again, oh, Hindi vachane kutte ke dun tedi ke tedi rehte is what's happening it. And simple steps to develop discipline, very simple steps. To have clearly defined goal, morning we talked about goal, you need to have the clarity of thought. To develop a definite plan of action to accomplish the goal. Once you've drawn up a plan, you need to stick to that plan. Don't deviate from that. I'll tell you, in Hyderabad, we have killed the cyber towers in the area of high-tech city. I was one member on that project committee. And when we were negotiating with the various vendors, finally L&T was shortlisted. And we were having discussions with them. And we told L&T, you had to complete this building by 6 months. That is 180 working days exactly. And they said, yes, we'll take up and we'll do that. I said, if not, there's a penalty clause. It's a huge penalty. You'll have to pay for it. They committed in writing. They said, we'll do it. They have gone back, worked out the entire plan. By the end of first week, what they're supposed to, by the end of second week, what they're supposed to, by the end of third week, and so on, weekly timetable, the entire thing is planned. And every week, they were taking that as if the deadline. And only when you work that way, then you can reach the 180th day, you'll be able to hand out the building. In fact, they handed out the building to us on 179th day, not 180. Please know this. So don't think that you plan for that 6 months, in a 6 months time. No, they planned every week, and every that week's work, that week has to be completed. They were racing against time, and the way they were working, they deployed manpower, everything is machinery, everything was there. And everything they used to plan once and keep things ready. So work will not stop anywhere. So it's not the end goal, even the, that's what I, morning I said, you have to have the milestones also. You have to have weekly targets, short-term goals and long-term goals, we talked about it. That's how they have done it. And they delivered, though they asked for 180 days, they delivered on 179th day. There is a big party thrown and saying that, yes, this we have done it. All that is possible, my dear friends. To a definite plan of action to accomplish the goal, you need to have it. My dear young friends, dare to dream and strive to achieve for that. It is said in Sanskrit, kalpana to sankalpana to parikalpana to rupa kalpana. Kalpana is dream. Sankalpana, the power of determination, it says. Diksha, power of determination. Parikalpana, it says, what is the plan of action you have it. And if you can take care of these three, that is kalpana, sankalpana, and parikalpana. Rupakalpana, the picture emerges right in front of you will happen. Are we dreaming big? Are we having the power of determination to complete the task on time? And do you have a plan of action? And if you can take care of these three things, yes, the picture will emerge right in front of you can happen. Yes, you need to think about it. And you need to say, to close the mind to all negative thoughts and influences. You close the mind to negative thoughts, negative influences. There are people who will keep saying, you can't do it, you can't do it. There is new time. Prove them that they're wrong. Morning, we discussed the story of Arunima Sinha. She proved, in spite of all the difficulty, she achieved the success. There are people with negative mindset. They say they discourage you, demotivate you. But you should be able to move forward. That's what we are talking about. It's very, very important. You need to move forward. To close the mind to all negative thoughts and negative influences people may come in. And stay focused on the goal and start working. That's the discipline we are asking. The way Arunima Sinha achieved it. So all that is possible. For which you need to find a coach or a mentor or a friend who will hold you accountable. Let's say you worked out the entire plan and you said, this is what I do in the first week, second week, and so on. Anywhere you are not able to complete the target of the week, your friend should be able to gala pakad gaya, pushna chahiye. That is the true friend. Right, guy, you said you'll complete by this weekend. This is what you're not done. Why you're not done? Your friend should be able to question you. That is a true friend. This is what you need to have it. So to find a coach or a mentor or a friend who will hold you accountable, you need to be answerable to that. Because you said by the end of first week, you'll do it. By the end of second week, you'll do it. By the end of third week, fourth week, and so on. You need to follow me. What are the tasks you have taken up? If we this people are putting up this, if we study more hours, they call bookworms. Don't care about that. It is you, your life, you are important to you. Let me tell you. If you start listening to all that, just ignore it, I'm telling you. Then you will not be able to achieve your goal, what you set for yourself. This is what I would say. People are always criticized. There are people to always criticize. Whatever the good you did, people criticize. And even the best you did. I have seen there's today in the political system, opposition leaders start criticizing everything. Whatever you do, still they criticize it. Today this party, tomorrow some other party will come. There's all anyway. Parties will change, but you may not be knowing because you're all too young. When Mrs. Indira Gandhi was the prime minister, that time the leader of opposition was Atal Bihari Vajpayee. And when Atal Bihari Vajpayee speaking in the parliament, she used to listen with utmost attention. Because he used to attack point wise. Madam, you have done this, you said this, this is what is happening. And he does a lot of homework. It's not that just speaks in the parliament. Once we had to negotiate with the US government for importing some arms. And she identified a member of parliament, you know, parliamentary committee to go and negotiate with them. And she requested Atal Bihari Vajpayee to be the chairman of this committee. Her party MPs said, what is this, madam? When we are here, how can you put our question leader as the chairman of this committee? You know what her response is? Vajpayee is hardcore Indian at heart. I know anything good for the country will do it. That is a conference she had on Vajpayee. It's known for them. In fact, these days people do all kinds of things in remaining in power. Atal Bihari Vajpayee, once in parliament, he was short by one vote in continuing in the government. He just said, his colleagues told him, sir, we'll get that fellow. He said, no, no, please don't do that. He resigned and left the parliament. There are some people who certain discipline, they have it. So to find a coach or a mentor or a friend who will hold you accountable, you need to. In fitness, there are no shortcuts. If you do shortcuts, it'll short circuit your life. In fitness, there are no shortcuts. It involves immense discipline and hard work. This is very, very important. My dear friends, take care of our health. We all read in the school days, health is wealth. How many of you do regularly exercise? Whatever is coming to, I'm not saying anything. Maybe walking, jogging, running, swimming, dancing, skipping, yoga, whatever you want. It's your choice. How many of you regularly do exercise? Morning? What are the time you get it? Let's say maybe 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock. I don't want to question that. Hardly the present youth are doing the exercise. If you don't take care of your health, you will pay heavy bills to the corporate hospitals. I'm telling you. Whatever you earn, you'll have to pay that entire money to the corporate hospitals. Gone. My dear young friends, you're all young. Please, please get up early morning and do at least half an hour to 1 hour exercise, whatever you want. That's your choice. Maybe walking, jogging, running, some physical exercise, or swimming, or playing some game, maybe volleyball or whatever you want. It's your choice. Even dancing, no problem, because it's good exercise. If you don't invest this time of 30 minutes to 1 hour, your health will be problem. These days, I see quite often, today, majority of the people, right from the age of 20, they have multiple chronic disorders. They always say, I have pain here, I have pain here, and they keep on eating medicines. I worked in the area of medical sciences for some time. I know what it is. My dear friends, all these allopathic medicines, every pill is followed by ill. There are side effects. So avoid to the extent possible taking the medicines. In the last 50 years, I have not taken any medicine. I am not going to doctor as a patient, as a friend of the gone, personal requirements of the gone, not as a patient. Every morning, an hour's exercise, I do it. Earlier, we used to do physical exercise. Today, I do only a little bit of yoga and more of pranayama. Because of age, body may not support. That's the reason I do that. If you feel half an hour to 1 hour, you can't afford to spend time, whatever the reasons, at least can you do 15 to 30 minutes deep breathing exercises that can take care of your health. It's the time you're investing for your own health. Otherwise, you'll have problems. The kind of junk food you're getting, the kind of pure air is not there in the environment, all that is creating problems to you. Please get up in the morning and do, if possible, 1 hour exercise, physical exercise, whatever you can. If not, at least 15 to 30 minutes of breathing exercise, you must do it. That will take care of you. Otherwise, it's a problem. It's a discipline you need to have. Otherwise, nobody can help you to do that. So for every disciplined effort, there are multiple rewards you'll get it. And lack of discipline leads to frustration in life. My dear friends, this will happen. Anything, I'm not listed out all. Somebody's putting agriculture. Yes, I just listed out a few of them. Then I will give a big list to you. Just thinking about ourselves, no, you have to do some physical exercise to build your health is very, very important. Okay, fine. So, my dear friends, discipline is a habit. If you have a spark, you can make a mark in your life. You have that spark and it can be ignited, can happen it. And fortunately, discipline is a habit that can be developed by practice. Discipline is a habit that can be developed by practice. You need to start practicing every day. First few days, you do the physical exercise under the guidance of a coach. Maybe for a month or 2 months, after that, you should take over and do on your own. Don't wait for the coach to come in every day. That's what you need to do. Initially, when I started yoga, yes, I had my yoga guru who taught me for a month. After that, I'm doing on my own. No, he doesn't come. So that's what should happen. Now I became guru to others. I do conduct programs in yoga. So that's what you need to do it. So fortunately, discipline is a habit that can be developed by practice. As we develop the habit of discipline, it only gets easier to feel more confident, stronger in character you become. When you start developing the self-discipline habit, you become more stronger, more confident, and you can achieve more can happen. That's the advantage of discipline that can lead to success can happen. Self-discipline is the act of cultivation. I'll give an example for this. Your mind is a highly fertile ground. Mind is a highly fertile ground. It depends on you. Whatever you plant, it will grow faster. Are you planting positive thoughts in mind or negative thoughts in mind? It's your choice. If you plant positive thoughts in mind, yes, it will go up. Good for you. If you start planting negative thoughts in mind, you will ruin yourself. You will kill yourself. So hence, it's very, very important. So self-discipline is an act of cultivation. You need to take care of it. You can't win the battle until you win over your mind. You need to win over mind. Control your mind. Don't allow it to go here and there when you're doing particular task. It should be focused on that task only, whatever you're doing it. You need to focus on it. And you can't win the battle until you win over your mind. You need to focus on it. And it required you to connect the today's actions to tomorrow's. Whatever the effort you're putting in today or this month or this year, this results you will get tomorrow. That is, at the end of your graduation, you'll get it. All that we will take up at the end, my dear friend, because if I give you one, there are 3,000 people, 3,000 people will start talking, then it's not possible because I can't stop. Once I give it to one person chance, I can't stop the other. That's not correct. So hence, we'll wait till the end. There I'll certainly give you a chance to speak. That's how I do it. Because time is limited here. That's the problem. That's the reason I'm not giving the time to you. Sorry. So it is required you to connect today's actions to tomorrow's. So today's actions, what the effort you're putting in is the result you'll get tomorrow. This is what's going to happen. What's the sincere effort you're putting in these 3 years? You will get the benefit. At the end of third year, you will get the benefit can happen. That's another way to look at it. And confidence comes from discipline. Your self-confidence develops from self-discipline can happen. Discipline is prescription or description, but not restriction by anybody. Please note this. Discipline is prescription or description, but not restriction. Nobody uses self-discipline, we're talking about it. It's not that somebody is putting on you. You need to take the self-responsibility has to happen. Change. You need to change your habits to fall in line with the discipline. Change is required. You change it. It's very, very important. You need to focus on it. Change is challenging in nature. Any change you want is challenging in nature. It's a challenge to get up early morning and do something. It's a challenge. And surrender is tempting and it gets easier with practice. Surrendering to that things will get easier, my dear friends. So don't tempt yourself to think. The good thing is that it takes less energy to remain disciplined than to regain it. To regain is a very, very difficult process once you lose it. Let's say when I resigned my job in 2014, I could have said, let me now relax. I did not relax. Right from the second day, I started going around the college and conducting programs because with Corona, I'm not going to call it COVID-19 situation. Otherwise, I go to the college, conduct a full day program. It's not just lecture alone. There'll be a lot of activity based will happen. Some fun, all that will happen. But in this online, all that is not possible. We're just doing lecturing, we're doing it. Otherwise, some activities, some games will happen. As part of the topic, which are relevant to that, all that will happen. But today, because of the COVID situation, we are not able to move out of the house. That's the reason we're doing only online things. That's happening. And the ability to control our emotions, actions, words, and thoughts has always been one of the man's most difficult tasks. Go back to school days. Our teachers have taught us you need to control anger yourself. When you get angry, what our teachers have taught us, just count 1 to 10. In the meantime, you'll cool down. That's all. Or when you get angry at somebody, just hold for a minute. Don't scold him or shout at him. Just recall what all good things he has done in the past, either to you or to the society. Automatically, you'll cool down. That's what you need to do. So, the ability to control our emotions, actions, words, and thoughts has always been one difficult. Learn to say no to your destructive feelings. Never say, I can't do it. There's nothing called you can't do it. Everything you can do. Power of determination can do it. Power of discipline can help you to achieve it. Power of devotion to the job what you've taken up can happen. Power of dedication, which you have, it can happen. That's it. So learn to say no to your destructive feelings, uncontrolled cravings, and selfish desires. You should be able to say no. It's very, very important. And you can learn the self-discipline. Discipline, learn from ants. You can learn from ants. The way they move around in a single line, that's what happens for them. They just move on a single line can happen. They don't bother. Even if you put your finger in the middle, it just bypasses that and still continues its journey is what happens. So you can learn lesson from the ants also. Without a mistake, they march one after the another in a line. That's what ants are doing it. Without any dispute or accident, they move about in the order in which they are moving it. But everywhere in life, man finds loopholes to divide it. Ignore diversions. Even if you put your finger, in an ant's path, it just walks around and it soldiers on, continues further its journey, can happen it. It won't let your stupid finger hinder its work, whatever the work it's doing it. And you shouldn't do the same and not let silly problems get in your way and make you to divert it. That should not happen. Nature teaches us many things. Morning, I was talking about the crane, the way it highly focuses, comes down from heights and picks up the fish and goes back in the air. So that teaches us you need to stay focused and you need to fast, all that it teaches us. The same way ants teaches us discipline. Look at the plant. It says you have to grow. Every day it's growing. The same way you also need to grow. That's what it teaches us. Nature teaches us many things. It depends on us, how we look at things. Beautiful nature. You need to look at it. Self-discipline is like a muscle. Some of you may be going to gym. Okay. The more you train it, the stronger your muscles becomes. Some of you may be going to gymnasium. And self-discipline is like a muscle. The more you train, the stronger the muscle becomes. The less you train it, the weaker you become. It happens. Hence, my dear friend, that's what I'm telling you. You need to have physical exercise to make your body strong. It's very, very important. You need to do that to take care of it. All that you need to do, it's very, very important. And just it takes muscle to build muscle. It takes self-discipline to build self-discipline. Your muscles strengthen the muscles. The same as self-discipline, strengthen the self-discipline can happen. The only bad thing about self-discipline is it's easy to give up. This is where you need to be stay focused and stop on it. Tempting. Friends are tempting and all that. You should be able to bold enough to take certain decisions and stand by those words what you said. It is very, very important. You need to look at it. That's an area where you need to stay focused and stop on it. And the goals with discipline leads to accomplishments. Your goal, whatever you have it, if combined with discipline, you can accomplish the goal, you can achieve the goal, you can realize the goal can happen. I never met a person who wasn't successful. That didn't have the great amount of self-discipline within them, their life. If you're self-disciplined, you're bound to succeed. If you don't have that, sorry, don't expect success to come in. They all are very, very important. You need to stay focused and stop on it. Self-discipline is being able to perform the task which is given to you, which is assigned to you. There's a deadline for which it has been given. You need to do that. Like in the morning, I was telling you, by December 2021, all of you should be good in communication skills. Effective communication skills. Get onto the stage and do that. In the communication skills, I'll put in a simple word for you to understand. What you know is not important. What you say is less important, but how you say is more important. I repeat again for your benefit. What you know is not important. What you say is less important, but how you're saying is more important. That's what we talk about communication skills. You need to develop it. Excellent presentation skills are required. There's an art, it's not a science. You need to have art, you need to have practice, should happen it. So self-discipline is being able to perform and being able to keep your life on schedule. Because my dear friends, time, the train will not wait for you, the flight will not wait for you. You had to be there before time. The same way here, you need to maintain the schedule, whatever you're trying. Every day morning when you get up, list out the tasks what you're supposed to do today. And once list out all the tasks what you're supposed to do, can you classify them into high priority, medium priority, and low priority? High priority tasks you have to do at the earliest possible opportunity, if possible in the morning before you go to the college, you have to finish up the tasks. Medium priority tasks, you can afford to complete it before the end of the day. Low priority tasks, you can afford to ignore. Nothing will happen. Don't worry. That is how you need to plan your entire activity and then implement the plan. That's what self-discipline we're talking about. So being able to keep your life on schedule, being able to keep commitments and priorities. What are the commitments you've done it? You have to keep up. I don't know. You may not be knowing. There's one of the old movie of Shatrughan Sinha. Pran jai par vachan na jai. Once you give a word to somebody, you have to stand by it. Or some of us read the story of Satya Harichandra. So all these are stories to inspire us. Yes, you need to stand by the words what you talked about. Being able to keep commitment and priorities and meet deadlines is essential to success. This is what self-discipline is. Self-discipline is being able to perform, being able to keep up your life on schedule, being able to keep commitments and priorities and meet deadlines is essential for success. It's very, very important. I have another question coming up. Go back to school days. Let's say you went to school and you returned, and naturally, generally, parents will say, "Arey beta, pehle homework complete karna, uske baad jaake khelna." First, you finish that homework and you can go and play. Right? So, did you finish the homework? Did you finish the work? And only after that you went for a playing in your school days and going back, taking back to the childhood. Generally, your parents say, "Beta, pehle homework kar lena, uske baad khelna." Did you finish the homework? Yes or no? Yeah, go ahead. Others, please type it. Did you finish the homework and then went for games or whatever you wanted to do it? That's enough, friends. That's enough. Oh, let me catch this person. One of you typed no. Why do you say no? Ravi Kumar, can you explain? Ravi Kumar, why do you say no? There's also one more person has come up saying that no. Vandana, why do you say no? Vandana D. Can both of you explain why do you say no? When all others are saying yes, there's also one more person has come in. By mistake. Okay, fine. No problem. Okay, I accept it. No problem. There's also one more person, Sneha Matthew. You also say no. Why? Bindu also says no. Why? Why do you say no? That means you never bothered your homework. You just thrown the books and went and played. Is that what you want to see? Yes. So you are not, you just threw it and gone. No, that part I'm not able to. I don't know whether you understood the question or not. I said, did you finish the homework? Let me ask the difference. What is the difference in finishing the work and completing the work? We say we have finished the work. We have completed the work. What is the difference between these two words? Difference between finish and complete. What is the difference in finish and complete? I finished my homework, I completed my homework. So what is the difference? I finished my homework, I completed my homework. What is the difference? Yes. Well, let me tell you, finish is always with reference to time. Completion is with reference to quality. That is the difference. Complete is with reference to quality, finish is with reference to time. Is what we talk about. So that's very, very important. You need to focus on it. So learn small, small things is a big difference. I've been asking very simple questions right from morning. Look at how simple they are, but somehow we don't look at these things. So the discipline of clear thinking is very, very important. Clearly, you must think it. I have a question, one more question coming up for you. What is the difference between creative thinking and critical thinking? What's the difference between creative thinking and critical thinking? What's the difference between creative thinking and critical thinking? Yeah, someone has typed it. It's innovative thinking. And the critical thinking is analysis, substitution, innovations. Creativity is innovation. Critical thinking is analytical thought. Think differently. Thinking out of the box. Okay, let me give the answer. Creative thinking is divergence and critical thinking is convergence. Okay, answer. I repeat again. Creative thinking is divergence. critical thinking is convergence. Let me explain you why it's right. Let's say four of you formed together and you started brainstorming it. And you may get a lot of ideas. Just list out on the blackboard or whiteboard or notebook, whatever it is. That's what we call divergence. It is creative. Different people throw different ideas. Let's list out. That's a creative thing we call divergence. Critical thing is finally you look at the merits and demerits of each one of them. Finally, select the one which is the best suitable in a given situation and you implement it. That's why we call it is convergence. All of us now finally agree, yes, this is what the path we follow. It. So my dear young friends, answers make it short, sweet and crispy. Don't give long answers. Who has got time today to listen to all that long answers, my dear friends? So same way in the interviews also, you need to be short answers. If you give long answers, you will be caught and they will ask more and more questions to you. So be careful. Don't give him chance, the recruiter, to ask more questions. That's an area where you need to focus on it. Otherwise, you'll be in trouble yourself. It can happen. Okay. And the discipline of time management is very, very important. You need to manage your time, whatever the time available to you. And discipline of courage, be courageous to face situations. That's very, very important. And discipline of excellent health habits, you need to have it. Health is wealth. If you don't take care of it, then you land up in trouble. And discipline of regular saving and investing is what you need to look at it. You need to save your time and money, other resources, and invest it for a good cause. You need to do it. Don't spend it. Morning, we talked about spending or investing time in the college. It's an investment you are doing it. And so discipline of regular saving and investing should happen. It. And discipline of hard work combined with smart work, you need to do it. Intelligently, you must be able to use your time, resources, and all that. Is very, very important. And focus on continuous learning. My dear young friends, learning doesn't stop after complete graduation. Learning is a lifelong process. That's where I would say, learn fast, unlearn faster, relearn fastest, you need to read. I repeat again, learn fast, unlearn faster, relearn fastest, you need to read. Certain theories are disproved. We don't need any more of them. So that's why I say unlearn. And relearn, some new things have come, so you have to relearn. This has to happen. Learning is a lifelong process. It's not going to end the moment you complete your degree. You may not be attending formal classroom, but you have to learn. You need to constantly update your knowledge or outdate. Choice for you to decide. Update or outdate. So learning is lifelong. I'll give a simple example for you to understand it. Say, for example, pencil, all of you know. Pencil maker told the pencil. This is a pencil, all of you know. Pencil maker told the pencil, you can do nothing at last. Then pencil asked, why did you create me if I'm so useless? He said, if you have to be useful to the society, you have to go through a painful process of sharpening the skills. You need to sharpen the skills. The same way here, as human beings, we need to sharpen our skills. It's a hard process. When a pencil is getting sharpened, can you imagine how painful it is for the pencil to get sharpened? The same thing is true for us. Sharpen our skills. The second thing he told the pencil is, the most important component is lead, graphite. If it is not there, you're useless. The same way for a human being, the brain is given by the God. It has enormous power. Please use that power for your own betterment of life. Enormous power is there. For us to use it or lose it is our choice. So first is a pencil. Is if you have to be useful, you have to go through painful process of sharpening. The same is true for us. We have to go through painful process of sharpening our skills. The second is said to the pencil, the most important component is lead or graphite. If not, they're useless. The same way for a human being, you have the brain power. Please use it. The third, he said, is you should not only write, it should be erasable. Not only writing, it should be erasable. That's where earlier I talked about learn, unlearn process has to go on. That's what he wanted to teach us. The finally, he told the pencil, wherever I ask you to write, you must write. You and I use a pencil and write in a notebook or a paper. Look at the small little child. He goes and writes on a rough wall surface. Rough wall surface. It wrote there also, it did not complain. Please note this. The same way in Hindi we say, वो क्या बोलते हिंदी में, नाचना नहीं आए तो आंगन टेढ़ा है, आड़लेक मध्य लोड़नाड़. So my dear friends, don't complain of things. You should be able to perform in any given situation. You should be able to do it. That's very, very important. You need to focus on it. So learn even many things we can learn from so many things. Pencil has taught so many things. Look at it. So it's for us to look around and learn so many things can happen. So focus on continuous learning is what you need to do. A policy, make a personal no excuse policy and stick to it. No question of excuses. Once you've drawn a schedule, you must implement it. With all sincerity, with all determination, you do it, results are bound to come. Whatever you're looking for can happen. Every compromise in behavior greases the wheels for another compromise. वो बोलते हैं ना, एक झूठ बोला तो हजार झूठ बोलना पड़ेगा. Once you tell one lie, you tell another lie. It's a chain will happen. So it's important. Every compromise behavior greases the wheels for another compromise. Absolute rule of discipline. If you don't discipline yourself, you are sure to be disciplined by others. Take it from me. If you do not discipline yourself, you are sure to be disciplined by others. Maybe first parents, second teachers, third police will take care of you. This is what happens. So it's very, very important. If you don't discipline yourself, you are sure to be disciplined by others. First, initially parents and family members, second teachers, finally the police will take care of. So don't land yourself in trouble. I'll give some action points to practice your self-discipline. First and foremost, positive attitude. Don't allow any negative thoughts to come in. Positive attitude, positive approach, positive thinking, you need to have it. A person is not happy because everything is right in his life. A person is happy not because everything is right. He is happy because his attitude towards everything in life is right. Because his attitude towards everything in life is right, so he's happy. That's what you need. I repeat again for a minute. A person is happy not because everything is right in his life. He is happy because his attitude towards everything in life is right. Problems are common to all. Problems are common to you. Show me one person who doesn't have problems. Problems are common to all, but attitude can make a difference. Your attitude can make a difference. Can happen. And a strong and positive attitude created more miracles than any other thing in life. Strong and positive attitude can create more miracles. This can happen. So be positive to all this. Positive thinking, positive attitude, positive approach you need to have. And never allow negative thoughts to come in. So, what I meant by positive approach is 10% how we make it, 90% how we take it is what it makes a difference. Attitude is a little thing that makes a big difference can happen. Your attitude determines the altitude to which you can climb in your career path can happen. What the approach you are, what the thinking you are. Positivity is very, very important. You need to do hard work. It's very, very important. Ensure the company of positive people. Ensure the company of good people. Ensure the company of good friends. That's the reason as parents we are worried. Sometimes we keep asking the children, there are those who are, who is your friend? What is he? We keep asking. We are worried. You need to have a company of good people. It's very, very important. Satsang chahiye. Company of good people is very, very important. Ensure the company of positive people. It's very, very important. You need to have that. And read good books that provide positive motivation. And these days, you have a lot of videos on YouTube, and you can watch some of those videos which can give you boost to the thinking process can happen. Excellent videos are available. Please watch them. Like I was telling you in the morning, Arunima Sinha's videos are available. And I talked about Ansar Ahmed Sheikh's videos. So many such videos are available which can help you to build that positive spirit can happen. And be active, be proactive. Be active all the time. Be proactive. Before the problem comes, why don't you wake up and start doing it? It's like I tell you, you need to do everyday morning exercise. Or you want to wait till the disease comes and we talk about it. That's too late to talk about it. So be active and be proactive. Be a self-starter. Become action-oriented. as I said, you're all 18 plus age group. You need to be self-starter, action oriented. Don't expect somebody to come and tell you. Should not happen. And feed your mind with confidence-filling thoughts. Build the confidence in you. Build the courage in you. Otherwise, you lose out. The battle can happen. The armed forces who fight for the country at the battleground, at the borders of the country, they fight till the last breath of life. He knows that he is the only person now left over in the entire battalion, but he will not give up. He will not run away from the battlefield or hide somewhere. He will fight till the last minute. That was the lesson to be learned from the armed forces, our defense forces. My dear young friends, you talk about the cine people as heroes. Please don't use the word hero for the cinema fellows. No, movie fellows. The heroes are our armed forces, defense forces. They are heroes. Hamare jawan jo border pe fight kar rahe hamare liye, they are the real heroes. The second is farmers who are producing food for all of us. They don't know whether they're going to get the crop or not at the end of the season. Even if they get the crop, they do get the right price or not, but still they're continuing farming it. This is another person who can be called as hero. Third is your own parents are heroes. In spite of all that financial difficulties they have, still they are funding your education. They are giving you everything possible in their limits. These three are the real life heroes. That movie fellow, don't call him heroes. You can call them as lead actor of the movie. That's all it is. He's the lead actor of the movie. They're not heroes. Heroes are our armed forces, defense forces who are fighting for us at the borders of the country. The second is farmers, agriculture who are doing it. Third is our own parents. They are the real life heroes. Those people are only real life heroes, or you can just call them as lead actors. They are not real actors. Maybe Sonu Sood is an exception. We have seen the way he helped during the COVID-19 times, the way he came forward and did a lot of help. Yes, he is a real life hero. This is what I mean. So don't use the word hero for these people. No, no, please. Think about it. So fill your mind with confidence-filling thoughts. Improve your self-esteem, self-image, and does your self-confidence lead to self-development and all-round development can happen. This is what's going to happen. You need to stay focused. And practice the habit of living in the present. Don't think about tomorrow. What you're doing today is more important. Don't talk to me about yesterday. Yesterday is history, gone. Don't talk to me about tomorrow. Tomorrow is a mystery. Don't talk about it. My dear friend, don't put this question again and again. I have in mind, put this question only at the end. I will answer it. This is the third time you're putting the question. I have seen that question. So I'll come back to it. At the end, you put this question, I'll certainly answer it. I have seen that question. Because now I have to talk about the topic also. It's very important. So fill your mind with confidence within thoughts. Improve self-esteem can happen. Practice the habit of living the present. Don't talk to me about yesterday. Yesterday is history gone. Don't talk to me about tomorrow. Tomorrow is a mystery. Nobody knows whether tomorrow exists or not. What we have is today. How best we utilize the day is important for us. You need to think about it. And model yourself after successful people. Do not ignore the lessons learned from the failure stories also. You need to read both success stories and failure stories. Success stories, model yourself after those people and learn from the failures. Why they failed? What made them to fail? And so you will not commit that mistake. That's the reason you need to read both. You need to focus on it. And set your SMART goals. Implement, review, revise, replan, and re-implement unit. Implement the plan, whatever. Review it from time to time. Revise if necessary. Replan if necessary. Re-implement it, you need to do it. Conquer doubt, fear, and anxiety, and also control your anger. This is what you need to do as part of self-discipline. Conquer your doubts, whatever you have. My dear friends, what are the doubts you have? Please raise in the classrooms. Don't keep it yourself. And overcome the fear, what you have, anxiety, and also control your anger. Otherwise, you will spoil your relations. Finally, exercise and meditate. Keep going and growing should happen. Keep going, going. Growing can happen. Tips to build a self-discipline. Goal setting has to happen. That we discussed in the morning at length. The next entire planning has to be done. Then not only plan, implement the plan is very, very important. That's what I always say. Government policies are excellent, be it state government or central government. It is only failure in implementing things. So that's why implementation is important. daily reinforce or re-examine about our goal achievements. You need to do everyday assessment. Am I in the right path? Am I putting right effort, requisite efforts? Do I have the required resources? All that has to be constant. You need to look on it. And raw diet, healthy diet, raw foods, vegetables, but not junk food, should eat it. And productive pairing your wants, and you should do it. You need to decide whether you want to run faster or run different. Run faster than others if you can. Otherwise, please change your path and look at some other path maybe. Since your friend is good in cricket, you can't be good in cricket here. Don't think that will happen. No. Each and every one of us are born unique in this world, let me tell you. Even among the twins, they are different, let me tell you. Me and my brother were twins. We've gone in totally different directions. He has gone into business side and I've gone into academic side. And business, he had ups and downs. He had some problems. But then luckily, at the end, yes, he could come out of it. So there are two different things. Never do that kind of things has happened. And you need to, if you can run faster than others, please run faster. Otherwise, think of a different path in which probably you can succeed it. Otherwise, you're wasting your time. You're losing the time. Can happen. And in Hindi, they say, bhag lo ya bhag lo. Bhag lo means run away. Bhag lo means take part in the activity. That's how they put it. Know your nature. Work in the mornings or night, whatever you want. Because some of the people are habituated to work early morning. Some of the people are habituated to work late night. It's your choice. I'm not going to say anything on that. And advanced decisions has to happen. And otherwise, you lose out. The time can happen. Don't delay in decision making, whatever decisions you wanted. And don't waste weekends. The weekend, let's say your Sunday is a holiday. Of which 6 hours allocate for your studies, remaining 18 hours do what you want. These are what else. 6 hours allocate for your studies, remaining do what you want. No problem. I'm not going to question that. Every day, can you spare 4 hours for your studies? That's a minimum I'm asking for it. And given a choice, I'd like to extend up to 6 hours per day. This is what the minimum investment you have to do if you really want to excel in your life. This is what needs to be talked about. You need to think about it. So, and let me talk about what is okay and what is not okay in life. It's okay if you don't know the answer. Because nobody can claim that I know everything. Even I don't want to claim it. Nobody can answer everything. Not possible. There are some limitations. It's okay if you don't know the answer. But it's not okay if you don't even pay attention to the question which is being asked in the interviews. That's not okay. It's okay if you don't score high marks. It's okay if you don't score high marks. But it's not okay if you don't do assignments. It's okay if you miss a class. Maybe for genuine reason, you have fever or something. It's okay. It's not okay if you bump the class. There's no genuine reason you're just skipping the class. That's not acceptable. It's okay if you don't help someone. It's okay if you don't help someone. But it's not okay if you harm anyone. Don't do that mistake. It's okay if you don't win the prizes in a competition. But it's not okay if you don't participate. Participating in the competitions with sincere practice is important. Winning or losing is secondary. It's very, very important. So it's okay if you don't win the prize, but it's not okay if you don't want to even participate. That's not correct. It's okay if you're not yet chosen your destination, where you want to go. But it's not okay if you lack focus and do not know where you are heading it. That's not correct. It's okay if you do not achieve your goals. That's not an issue at all. But it's not okay if you say, I don't have goals at all for my life. That's not acceptable to us. It's okay if you make mistakes. Yeah, we do mistakes. But it's not okay if you do not attempt to correct it. If you do not attempt to correct it. So you need to stay focused. I have another question coming up for you. What is the difference between ability and capability? What's the difference between ability and capability? I'm asking very, very simple words which you people use it regularly. What's the difference between ability and capability? First two lines of okay, not okay. Yes. It's okay if you don't know the answer, but it's not okay if you don't pay attention to the question itself. That's what it is. Okay. What's the difference between ability and capability? Mm-hmm. Yeah, only 2% responded so far. Fine, that's enough to me. Thank you for responding to my question. Let me give the answer to you. That's enough. Please stop. Enough. Ability is present, capability is future. That's why I was telling you in the morning, you're all capable of reaching greater heights in life. That helped you to achieve the goal what you wanted. Ability is present, capability is future. Look, answers, you can make it simple. Don't make things complicated. It can happen. It's for you to think about it. These are all small, small things which can help you to think about. For example, what is the difference between knowledge and skill? Again, these words, use it. They are not new words. What is the difference between knowledge and skill? Yeah, someone has responded. Let me see. Knowledge is wisdom. No. Sorry. No, friends. Fine. That's enough. Please stop. No more typing, please. Please stop. The answer is simple. I don't know. People make complicated everything. The answer is simple. Knowledge is what, skill is how. Okay, answer. I repeat again, knowledge is what, skill is how. Okay, answer. Yeah, one person responded, how. How you do things is skill. What you know is knowledge. Knowledge is what, skill is how. Look at how simple the answer is. That's how you need to prepare yourselves. You need to do it. Can be happened. And then please raise questions to your own friends, and that would help it be win-win situation to both of you can happen. So hence, it's good habit to raise questions to your own friends, can help you to achieve something in your life, can happen. Yeah, let me come to the last part. Self-discipline means aligning your energy with your values and priorities, what you have. Self-discipline means aligning your entire energy, entire effort, with your value systems, what you have it, and with your priorities, what you have it. You have to focus on the tasks before yourself. Let other temptations and distractions not adversely affect you. All the temptations which are there should not affect you, should not happen. So you have to focus on the tasks before yourself and let other temptations and distractions should not adversely affect you. Like it's something like some of you do, bunk the college and go to the movie on first day, first show, as if it's so important. What is your area? You can go in the evening or you can go on the Sunday or wait for a month for TV free me ajayega. You can watch on TV freely. Why you're bunking the college and going to the theater and waste your time and hard-earned money of your parents and you're missing out the class here. You can wait. On Sunday you can go. The fellow is not going to remove the movie from the theater. And some of you go and buy in black. I don't know why you people are doing it. Because you have parents, you do it. So discipline is a self-imposed, which endures frustration, disappointment, pain in the survey of your higher goal, what you have it. If you are self-disciplined, you can easily overcome frustration, you overcome disappointment, all that you can avoid it. And you can reach higher goals, you can reach it, can happen. It means willing to push yourself to the limits of your will and endurance. You need to be able to push, go beyond the comfort zone and work on it. It's very, very important. If this is what is required for the success. My dear friends, let me give an example for this. When an egg is broken from an outside force, what happens? When an egg is broken from an inside force, what happens? I repeat again. When an egg is broken from an outside force, what happens? When an egg is broken from an inside force, what happens? Yes? Omelette ho jayega. Okay. Yes. At least a couple of you have done good answer. Let me tell you, remaining all not good. Let me give the answer. When egg is broken by external force, life ends. Khatam ho jayega life. When egg is broken from internal force, the chick comes out. The small little one comes out of that. So I repeat again, when egg is broken from external force, life ends. When egg is broken from internal force, life begins. The chick comes out. The same way, don't expect your parents and teachers to keep putting pressure on you. Oh, kar, ye kar, then you'll get frustrated. That should come within you. Yes, I must do these things. I must excel in my life. I must make my parents proud of me. All that, you must have it. So my dear friends, the pressure has to come from within you, not from outside. The way I give the example, if egg is broken from outside force, life ends. Khatam ho jayega. When it's broken from inside force, the chick comes out, the little one comes out, is what in. So the pressure has to come from within you, not from external. That's what we talk about self-discipline. Discipline need not be harsh. Discipline doesn't mean it should be harsh. It can take the form of resolve and determination, then direct your choices, is what we're talking about. I repeat again. It can take the form of resolve and determination, that direct your choices, to put you on the right track, on the right path, to take the right choices at the right time, at right destination, is all what we're talking about, self-discipline. It's not good for sin. So don't expect things to come from outside. The things has to come from within you. Like I say, you should be ever hungry for knowledge. So much to gain, so much to learn. What we know is very, very little. The learning is much more. You need to focus on it. Has to be lived at it. I don't know. This person is not leaving me. I'm going to answer this question. Anyway. So, it can take the form of resolve and determination that direct your choices can happen. And let's all join hands in transforming India as a global leader. How long we'll keep on listening? India is a developing country, transform it as a developed nation. That's where I need the support of youth, people like you. India has got the large youth force. So if all of us join and work for it, we can make India as a global leader. A new vision of India as a global leader, a new mission of continuous growth you need to have. You need to work with the missionary zeal for continuous growth. That's what we all need to put in it. And an enduring passion for progress. You must have that passion to excel in your life is very, very important. And a fusion of thought and heart is required. You need to synchronize your heart and mind has to be synchronized. And I repeat again, a new vision of India as a global leader, a new mission of continuous growth, you need to look at it. And enduring passion for progress, you must be passionate for progress. And a fusion of thought and heart is required. And let's all work for an action for universal welfare. We must be able to explore, export to other nations. That's the level to which we should raise to that issue. Yes, there's one person who's been continuously putting the question. Let me read that question for you. I'll be able to bring back the question. Let me read for you because he's been putting it, I think 3-4 times he has put this question. Where is it? Well, the question is, yes, put 2-3 times, yes, put. Yeah, I'm not going to look at anyway. The question was, if you read more, people call me bookworms. This is what, something like that, the question was there. My dear friends, whatever the activity you do, people will criticize you. Let me tell you. That is how the society is. Don't worry. If you're convinced that reading that book is important to you, please go ahead and read it. Don't worry about others. Because ultimately, you have to lead your life. Not that fellow is going to help you in reading. Will he feed you lifelong tomorrow? No, he's not going to do that. If you feel reading that book is important to you, if you feel that doing this particular task is important to you, please go ahead and read it. Do that. Don't worry about others. There are people whose full-time job is only to criticize others. That's what the answer I have. Any other questions? Yes. Now the floor is open to you. Now you can put the questions. I'll answer it. Well, friends, even if you postulate, sometimes you might fail. Maybe you don't have the full knowledge of that, full experience. That's the reason you fail. Maybe don't worry. Failure is a step for success. I don't know how many of you can recall. One of the scientists said, I will never say I failed 1,000 times. I discovered 1,000 ways that can cause failure. Thomas Alva Edison said it. So failure is not a crime, my dear friend. Don't be under the impression. You may have postulated, you went there. Maybe that knowledge was not sufficient, that experience was not sufficient for you. That reason you could not success. That's how I look at it. How to control patience? How to work on patience? Do meditation. That's one of the solutions which can give you the thing. Meditation. Yes. And difference between determination. Somebody put a difference between determination and dedication. Dedication is you are fully now focused on it. That means you don't allow your mind to go to other sides now. And determination is you are now putting all your efforts and energies on that. This is what happens. You dedicate your life for that. And then to determine to put in the best efforts. Let's say you took a film, acting is my career. That's the determination you've done it. Dedication, now fully dedication. And your best performance can happen. How to tackle self-doubt? Talk to some seniors, talk to elder persons who can help you. What are the doubts you have? How to come out of laziness? Beta subit, paan pe jod ja, excess karna shukr de laziness, sab kuch bhaag bhaag jayega. Ambience is what kind of environment we have it. Yes. And how to improve English communication? Any tips? Yeah, I can give you. I would suggest first read one of the standard newspaper. Like in the South, we say Hindu is one of the standard newspaper. Read the headlines. I'm not saying beyond that. Just read the headlines. And while in the college, talk to your friends and faculty only in English. Even if it's wrong, don't worry. The third is, I would say, listen to BBC News every day for 15 to 30 minutes. That's all what you need. It'll help you to, you need to have a friend who can help you and guide. Let me tell you, when I started, you know, I come from a local language medium. When I came to college, I had to English. In my class, one of my classmates comes from an English medium background and with a very good school he came. And his English too, excellent English, let me also admit. And my English was very bad and all kinds of mistakes, sentence formation was not there. And one day he caught me and he said, if you speak in English tomorrow onwards in this college, I'll kill you, he said. I said, I don't care for you, who are you? If you're a friend to me, please correct me. I know that my English is not good. I'm willing to help you improve myself. But if you say you should not speak English, who are you to dictate my life? I don't care. I'm going to continue this. And that's how I took a bold decision. I told him I continued, and today I'm able to speak to all of you. So I repeat again, first read the Hindu newspaper headlines. Now, point number one. Point number two, start talking to your friends and faculty in English while in the college. Third, listen to BBC News for 15 to 30 minutes every day. This will help you in improving your communication skills. How to make right friends? Observe them. What is their quality? What is the behavior? What is the approach? And then only you can make it. It sounds like, you know, when we arrange a marriage, the parents look at so many things before they give their daughter to the other house, right? The same thing is here, important. What is it? Is Times of India okay? Yeah. Times of India is also okay. Headlines, you can read it. No problem. Involve entertainment, responsibility, study, and daily tasks. That's what I said. Yeah, someone typed how to use discipline for making our daily routine in order to involve entertainment, responsibility, study, daily tasks, etc., etc. Okay, I already answered this question. Maybe I'll repeat for you. When you get up morning, just list out what all tasks need to do today. Or before you go to bed previous day, list out what all tasks need to be done tomorrow. Okay? Then put them, some of them are high priority tasks. Today you have to do it. If you don't do it, it will be a serious problem for you. Certain tasks are medium priority. Certain tasks are low priority. So now that then, when next morning when you wake up, you know that what are the high priority tasks you have written. Do it. Please attend it in the morning itself before you go to college. Complete those tasks. Medium priority, you can do it when you come back from the college. You can do it. There's a leisure period in the college. That time you can do it. Low priority activities, even if you don't do nothing, will happen. Just ignore it. That's how you need to go up and wait. What about me? I can't be present in things, but I have many dreams to conquer. Fine. Don't have too many things to conquer. Attempt one, succeed it, then you can go for the second one, third one, fourth one, can happen it. You want to do drive two boats at a time, nahi hota hai. Only one boat at a time you can do it. How to set goal in your life? You need to decide what is important to you in your life. Somebody wants to be a businessman, somebody wants to be a sportsman, somebody wants to be an actor, somebody wants to be, you know, it's individual choice. Maybe you need to think about yourself first. And once you have some clarity, may not be there, I understand. Then take the help of the faculty or elders in the family and then decide what you want. How to know what passion we are good at it? There are some psychometric tests which are available. You can take those tests that might help you to do that. Procrastination is bad, there's no doubt. What way to get constant mind? What do you mean? I don't know. Maybe you want to stay focused. Keep your thoughts aside, it's the best thing you can do. Meditation could be one of the solutions which will help you to focus on your thinking. Answer my question, please. What is the question? I want the question, I'll answer it. How to give ourselves get ready with special skills required in corporate world? How to keep ourselves get ready? My dear friends, subjects in your faculty of teaching or college teaching, along with that, you need to focus on soft skills. Communication skills, interpersonal skills, team performance, all that generally most of the colleges are conducting during the third year as part of the placement training, they are conducting the programs. And you can take active participation placement preparatory training, which colleges are conducting it. That's where you can learn those things. எனக்கு தமிழ் தெரியாது, கொஞ்சம் கொஞ்சம் தெரியும் சார். ஸோ ஐ கான்ட் ஸ்பீக் தமிழ், சாரி யார். மை தமிழ் இஸ் வெரி பேட். ஐ பிக் அப் ஓன்லி ஃப்ரம் தி ஆட்டோ வாலாஸ் அண்ட் டாக்ஸி வாலாஸ். ஸோ டோன்ட் மேக் மீ டு ஸ்பீக் தமிழ். How the personality? What become IPS? You can imitate it. It depends on you. If you want to really go for all India services like IAS and IPS, you can start preparation. And along with your degree subjects, you can start preparation for those things also. And I would say, better take coaching. Then that will give some direction for you to prepare it. Sorry, friends, I do not share my contact details because I go to so many guys, at least you know, a million students address. If I start giving my number to all those, then I will not have any time left. So this is, I'm sorry, I don't share my numbers. And on, okay, sir, thank you. What is it? Where are you from? I'm from Hyderabad, Telangana. Yeah, discipline is worth. There's no doubt in lifetime, even personal life, professional life, you need to have the discipline. You can visit the UPSC website. I don't know what exactly you want from UPSC. You can visit the UPSC website. It can give you complete details. What exactly you want, I don't know. How to overcome overthinking. Are zyada bhi mat socho beta. Phir pagal ban jaoge. No, no, don't. Just see what is required. To that extent, you need to focus on it. Then my past question, sir, I have texted long paragraph, but I'm not able to see that paragraph. I can see, I'll certainly answer. I have no problem. Tips for banking exams. All this banking, why not bank is only all competent exams. Speed and accuracy is very, very important. Number one. Number two, most of these test papers are available in the market in the form of books or websites and so on. Take those test papers, time set exactly, and attend those things at the end, check it, how much you got it. Because in all these content exams, time and accuracy are very, very important. That's how you need to practice it. How to convince parents if they are not happy with my career choice? Yeah, this is a good question. Let me answer it. How to convince parents that they are not happy with my career choice. Let me give an experience I had. I rarely come to degree college, actually. I go to mostly engineering colleges. Once I was addressing in one of the engineering colleges, the first year students, then I asked them, is anyone who says, this branch of engineering is not my interest, my parents forced me to come here. One girl stood up boldly and said, sir, yes, I am the one. And my parents forced me to take this computer science branch and I don't want to do it. I said, fine, then I'm a supporter of you, don't worry. Tell me then, what is your interest? You know, she said, sir, my interest is fashion technology. Great. It's one of the promising field. Please go ahead. Okay, that means I said, what parents said is, don't do it, what you want to do it. I did not stop there. And next I asked. I said, how much time you study for this computer science? Because already 3 months over college start, okay? Kitna time padte ho ghar pe? Sir, bas ek aadha ghanta, ek ghanta. Only half an hour to 1 hour she's studying. I said, are you really passionate about fashion technology? If so, the remaining time, leaving this 1 hour, you could have used for your fashion technology. Why did you waste your time? If that is your passion, that anyway, 1 hour only you're studying for your computer science branch, remaining time you could have used for learning fashion technology. Today, all the development websites, number one. Number two, you should be thankful to your parents who gave you CS computer science branch. Tomorrow, everything is technology driven. Your entire fashion technology is going to be using computer graphics and animation is going to happen it. And that would help you to better perform in the fashion technology industry. Can you combine these two fields together so that you'll be able to succeed in your life? This is how I answered that student. Okay. Students want to become police or army and wants to write the IP. Well, the recruitment of police is generally done by the state. State has got its own exams, state level it is. Recruitment of army done by the government of India, and they have their exams are separate. The both are not same, sorry. They are different things. Please tell some questions asked in interview. Generally, one of the questions we commonly ask is, tell us about yourself. You talk about, I have done BA or BCom, BSc, no, that you should not talk about it. What is the unique qualities you have? What is the special things you have that you should talk on that? Put the question again. Where is the question? I'm not able to see. If students want to become police, is this the question? Or I don't know which question. What should we answer for tell your weaknesses in the... Yeah, they don't say I don't have any weakness. Never say that. You see, yes, I have weakness. I identified this since in the last 1 year back. I've been working on it. Today, I'm a better person than what it was. Tips for IAS exam. You need to clear the preliminary IAS civil service prelims exams. You need to clear it. Then you come to a final exam. That's it. You have to clear it. Then third level comes to interviews. Three rounds it happens. And it's not easy to clear in the first attempt. Let me also tell you. Unless you say you're most brilliant person, then it's okay. Otherwise, it's not easy. People who attempt twice, thrice, they get cleared. Yeah, I think sir has come back here. Sir, one last question. I take it with your permission and then I'll hand over the session to you. To be a lecturer, what qualities to be needed for? To be a lecturer, first and foremost, is strong knowledge in the subject, what you want to teach. And second is excellent presentation skills, you need to have it. Third, you must be able to understand your students. These three qualities are required. Yeah, over to you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for such a wonderful session. Some of the key takeaways we have here on self-discipline, we have to learn from nature.
Yes.
As you're given an example of ants, beautiful example. Self-discipline helps us to overcome frustrations, lack of persistence approach. Basically, once you take a decision, you need to implement it.
Yes.
Discipline helps you to accomplish goals. Without discipline, there's no success. And I think this is one of the favorite, sir, which I liked it a lot. When no one is watching you, what is your behavior? I think this is really, yes. Very, very nice. We tend to think, what kind of behavior we have when nobody is watching us. Very nice, sir. And learn to say no in some situations, where your friends are insisting you and you have important work. Plan for every week and not for a year. You set a deadline and you plan it. That makes you a better person. Close minds to all negative thoughts. Again, a very nice one. Discipline is a habit that can be developed by practice. Absolutely right, sir. Confident comes from discipline. Change your habit for better discipline. Discipline, one of the bad things is discipline is easy give up. Again, sir, people tend to give up things because they don't fall in line and they lose hope somewhere. And this is very nice. Plan entire day's activity based on higher, mid and low priority, as you said. And one of the students also had posted the question. Very well answered, sir. Again, I like this one very much, sir. If you do not discipline, you are sure to be disciplined by others. That's so well said. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. And armed forces, farmers, and parents are real life heroes. This was a need of our people should know. The young generation should know, who are our real heroes. And run faster or run different. So nice, sir. So nice. It's very nice. Thank you once again for such an enriching session. I remember the quote of George Lorimer who said, you have to get up every morning with determination if you are going to go to bed with satisfaction. This quote of George Lorimer is totally justified today by Professor M.L. Saikumar, sir. As today we feel that we will go to bed with satisfaction that we have been enlightened with life skills knowledge. Thank you once again, sir. We have had very patient and lovely audience whose hunger for knowledge is seen in today's FDP. A lot of questions were posted. I once again thank all the participants for attending this FDP and making it a great success. So now we end this session 2 and let's meet tomorrow morning at 10:30 a.m. for session 3 of Power of Thinking. thank you one and all. Thank you all the participants. And once again, thank you very much, Sai Kumar sir.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye, sir.